Hi there. My name is Ole and I'm in charge of data and analytics here at Project A. We are regularly tasked with building high-performance data teams that can drive impactful initiatives and have learned a thing or two about that over the years. And today, we'd like to show you 4.5 mistakes to avoid when actually starting to set up your data team. Mistake number one, starting decentralized. Now, you can surely put every data team on sort of a spectrum between being very central and independent and being highly embedded within the business. Being highly decentralized means you're able to gather a lot of relevant domain knowledge, but it's surely not the right thing to start with. And that's because first, you need to have a central team and a central data platform in place that aligns on definitions, on a working mode, and on core pipelines and data sets. If you don't start out that way, decentralized analysts will be forced to create their single source of truth. And what happens? Well, depending on which report you look at, you will see different values for what your revenue is and what your numbers of customers are. Mistake number two, starting with data scientists. Now, don't get me wrong here. While the space has surely received a bit too much hype, resulting in too many boot camps, I still firmly believe that data science can serve as a competitive edge for any business. It's just not the kind of profile that you want to start your data team with. Your data scientists, once they've joined the company, should ideally stand on the shoulders of giants, so to say, by building their models on well-curated data sets that have already been developed by the core data team. We still, to this day, see data scientists spending 80% of their time just cleaning data and complaining the other 20% of their time about it. Now, what you would like to do instead is ideally help them by hitting the ground running and adding them a bit later to the team, but not starting out with a data scientist as your first data hire. Mistake number three, starting with tech discussions. Now, one mistake that too many companies still repeatedly do is they are getting too excited about the question of which technology to use. And who can blame them? There's so many VC dollars being poured into, well, creative content strategies to define new categories and position new tools in them. It is getting increasingly hard to navigate the modern data stack and understand which software to use for which use case. While the use case is what you should actually be starting with. Identifying which kind of initiatives really have an impact on your company's growth will serve you much better than defining first if you should start out with Snowflake or BigQuery. Buying the tech won't solve your problems. Investing in the right people to use the tech surely will. Mistake number four, starting the team within one of the main stakeholders. Now, there's surely one stakeholder that might be product, sales, or marketing that is screaming the loudest for additional insights or reports, and maybe even puts emphasis on a necessity for a data team, which is good. Problems quickly arise though if they simply go ahead and build one themselves. What happens very quickly is that prioritization of the team being built is heavily compromised, while for example, marketing quests might be served sufficiently, other teams will quickly feel left out because the core data team is actually reporting to one of the stakeholders. What happens eventually is that other teams might start their own data team as well, leading to even larger inefficiencies and an ongoing inability to align on definitions. And that is closely linked to point number 4.5, which is exclusively for especially SaaS companies. One thing you definitely want to avoid when starting out your data team is starting out with two data teams. And that unfortunately happens regularly, especially in SaaS companies where you have two very separate use cases for data. One is rather on the commercial side, where the team wants to find out how the customer journey looks like, and which factors eventually drive high contract values, while on the other side, you have a use case around product engagement and potentially want to feed that back to your actual clients via something like a client-facing analytics. Now, if you actually let these two teams grow separately, that will again lead to large inefficiencies as they are really working on the same kinds of data. You want to avoid that by any sense in order to have a scalable data team. So how should you start your data team instead? Now, obviously there are many ways to mess this up, but how do you get on the right track from the get-go? For us, it all starts with a tech-savvy individual and a strong business background, as well as a high degree of emotional intelligence. Now, this certain individual needs to be equipped with as much context as possible around the business and what it takes for the business to succeed. Executive buy-in is key here. Be ready to add a data person to your leadership at some point. Your first hire is then tasked with building meaningful relationships to key stakeholders in your business, which in turn helps to identify their needs as well as verify them. Once these needs are collected, you can outline a data platform that is needed to satisfy them and hire additional technical talent to actually build it. Once core data pipelines, definitions, and curated datasets are in place, you can start adding more specific roles like analytics engineers, machine learning engineers, and more decentralized analysts to make sure that the team scales and has a real impact. Doesn't sound that hard, right? We really hope the short video helps you in avoiding some of the common mistakes in building up a data team. It's surely an exciting journey to be on. And hopefully soon enough, your data team can provide the returns that everyone is hoping for. Thanks a lot for joining today, and see you soon.